Woo!
If you're today, you're a GH5 user or a Michael Four Thirds user, today is a great day for you. And let me tell you why. Today, May 25th, 2021, Panasonic just announced two cameras that are coming out today. The first one, and I don't really care about it. It's cool that they're coming out the reiteration, which is the GH5 Mark II. It's an improvement on the GH5 series, stuff like that, but it's more or less an iteration. The one that I'm really excited about, the one that everybody really cares about, is the GH6. It's like finally Panasonic listened, right? Because they kept quiet entirely during the 2020 year, right? During this, you know, the pandemic. But that was a terrible time for everything in terms of health and, you know, social distancing and stuff like that. But in cameras, every camera manufacturer came out with a camera, right? Sony, Canon, Blackmagic, right? Panasonic was surprisingly quiet, right? And didn't say anything. And people were thinking, you know, you just search on various forums and Facebook and things like that, and you would get heated discussions about, you know, Panasonic is not going to make any more GH cameras. It's the end of it. They're going to the S series, right? Today, Panasonic announced that they are staying with the MFT line, right? Michael Four Thirds, and not just with the GH5 Mark II, but also the GH6. Because they see that there's an intrinsic design benefits from using a smaller lens system. Those of you that have been following the news regarding, you know, the Lumix line and what Panasonic was doing, already was leaked a day ago was the GH5 Mark II. And I was like, oh, come on, Panasonic, you know what? Are you like, is this really okay? And I was in my cart, right, on my B&H shopping cart on the app, I already had the Sony A7S III and the various lenses lined up. If this is kind of like the last straw. This camera I'm filming off of is a GH5S. June 9th, 2021, ProRes RAW will recording via HDMI to a Atomos Ninja 5, which is also, I have that connected to on the top of the camera right now. So for me, this is a benefit, right? Because what does that mean? Before, I was recording in the 422, but ProRes RAW offers you more flexibility, right? You have higher data. Basically, you have more image data to play with now. But really, what we're really excited for is the GH5-6, right? Not the GH5 Mark II, right? I'm glad they're coming out, but honestly, that's just like a stopgap, right? To get people to pay attention so that we're waiting for the real thing. So here are the specs, okay? This is what we've been, Panasonic has shown through their live stream today, right? So it says a new image sensor and new engine. And of course at the top right here, I'm skipping, it says in development and will be here within 2021, right? So let's hope that it actually meets a date. If you've been paying attention to the things that are happening in the world, there's a silicon microchip shortage all over the world, right? And it doesn't matter whatever product that you have, everything from cars to computers to PlayStation 5s, right, are in shortage right now because of what's happened with the pandemic, etc. They have 422, 10-bit, DCI, 4K, 60p, unlimited video recording, right? So this is an advantage that Micro Four Thirds has. A smaller sensor compared to a full frame, it's more efficient, right? And produces less heat, theoretically. And so they're able to do these things, that unlimited recording. Panasonic was doing this 3 or 4 years ago. 10-bit, 4K, 120p, high frame rate or variable frame rate video recording. This is great because this is something that Sony is already offering on their A7S III, which is something I was leaning towards getting right now because I showed you in my phone that I was this close. 5.7K at 60p. Now that's great, right? So I would have been happy with 5.7K at 30, right? But they're saying 5.7K at 60. That is great, right? I mean, you're gonna hear the arguments out there. People are gonna say like, oh, you don't need more than 4K, stuff like that. I was like, okay, You know, I hear that all the time. It's like, do you still watch standard definition TV, right? Are you happy with, you know, antennas coming out? As a filmmaker, I'm always looking to get any type of advantage I can get, right? Any type of use that I can get. And having 5.7K and that allows me to push in to get, you know, crop in without losing resolution at 4K, that's great, right? Another thing that's been that I'm noticing about this, and another YouTubers kind of mentioned this, is that because it's at 5.7K, right, and it's basically, so that means that sensor is capable of that. It's probably like a 20 megapixel sensor, as opposed to something that's low, like in the teens or in the 10 megapixel or 12 megapixel, I think, which is like the Sony A7S III. And which means that when you're filming in 4K, it's oversampling, right? So that means that you're getting a potentially a sharper image. There's speculation of the price, which they're saying is about $2,500, which is the same which I what I paid for the GH5S. So that's not a bother to me. The big thing though, which is in 2021, you have to nail down, is autofocus, right? But the weakness of the GH5 series S included, and even the S1 series, their full frame of Panasonic, is their focus system, right? I've had good success with using my camera, the GH5S, and I put it in good situations. But the thing is, like, that's the thing. You kind of have to set it up for success. If you have an area that's, you know, more more brightly lit in the background and the foreground is dark, then it's gonna hunt back there. Or in times where I had the camera in good lighting and you can see it, you know, pulsing, right? Back and forth, kind of doing like a thing, and it's a kind of annoying when you can see things coming in and out very rapidly, right? And obviously you combat that by what I'm doing now. I just put it on manual focus because I'm not moving and it's right here. But as a independent filmmaker, you don't have a lot of people around you, or you're a vlogger, you like to have the flexibility of autofocus, right? To be able to lock on. I mean, Canon is doing phenomenal work with their autofocus. Sony has knocked it out of the park with their Sony A7 series. And, you know, you kind of hope that, you know, I think most users would be happy if it surpassed those, that's great. But honestly, that's my expectation. Can it be as good or even just slightly below would be good enough for me, right? I'd be happy about that. Because the autofocus in its current state, it's, for me, I've had a lot of success with it, but I've had a few misses too, where you kind of look at something like, oh man, it's out of focus, right? And you kind of deal with this thing like that. Some people are gonna say, well, you know, if you're a, you know, a filmmaker and stuff like that, you know, you're a pro, you don't need autofocus, manual focus. It's like, I will use every tool that I need and that is available to me. Why disable yourself, say, oh, you're a pro, you don't need that, right? I mean, how do you know, right? You might be in a position where you're the only guy filming it and then you need it to be doing something, right? Why not just have every tool available to you? Yes, if you have a crew, and you have somebody that can focus pool, you can do something great, but that's not available to everybody all the time, right? And so having a tool like a reliable autofocus would be essential to a independent filmmaker. Panasonic has really got to come up with something better than that, right? I don't know whatever they're going to figure out, some sort of computational algorithm, or to use something that's muchly overused AI focus, right? Like the word AI is everywhere these days, right? AI focus, autofocusing. I really don't care, right? All I want is something that is on par with what is being offered by other manufacturers, and then it'll be, in a sense, the perfect camera, right? To sum up everything, this is a great day if you are a GH5 user. Panasonic gave you, in a sense, what you're asking for, right? Which we wanted to, a camera that was updated for 2021 to compete with all the Canons and the Sonys out there. And the continuation of what they're saying to support Micro Four Thirds, right? And this is everything that we wanted, because a lot of questions were asked today or answered today about whether Panasonic was continuing the GH lineup or abandoning it, right? So today, we got that answer. Anyway, this is Jimmy from 1015 Studios. Take care, God bless, and I'll talk to you soon.